Welcome to Busy Works Beats. Actually, you know what? Wait, I gotta pause the stream. I'm sorry. Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're continuing the If I Produce For series. We're gonna do a live, and today we're gonna focus on If I Produce For Trippy Red. So shout out to It's Very Frosty Cold, because he made me go research the style Trippy Red. So let me know if we're live. I'm not even sure if we're live. I'm just assuming we are. Are we live? Can I get a five? Just 1 5. I don't need 8 5s. I just need 1 5. What's up, Django? I am doing okie dokie. You probably didn't expect me to say dokie, but I am doing okie dokie. So we're going to focus on Trippy Red. Trippy Red. Now, really, the style that people are concerned about is Honorable C-Note. He has a very specific, you know, distorted 808 sound that's like his thing. You know, from the Scary Freddy series or from the GTA 5. Oh, it's live. Good looks, G-Bass. From, what is that channel called? I forget the channel, but they used to do a series on GTA 5 where he would reenact Freddy Krueger as a GTA 5 character. And Honorable C-Note made, like, all the beats, I think. Scary Freddy. I think that's what it's called. So shout out to Honorable C-Note. Hold on one sec. Sorry, I messed up the live stream. I went live, then turned it off, then went live again. So people are probably confused right now because I messed that up. So anyway, the trick is, once we find an 808, we're going to make sure we distort it for one, and then second, we want to use triplets. So a lot of people kind of don't even know about triplets because they're so used to 4/4 timing. So instead of 1 2 3 4, triplets are when you count to three. So it's one, so it's like 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. It's a different way of counting. All right, so let's kind of get our stuff established. We need open hi-hat, just a low open hi-hat. Let's open that up. Now it's going to probably take me a little bit of time to find the haunted sounds in Omnisphere, but it's going to be an Omnisphere. So we want to go right click, fill each 4 steps for the open hat, so it hits every time. So it goes tss, 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 just like Metro Boomin. Okay, so we're going to have that. A little too fast. Now let's tap out the tempo. So we're around 130. Wait. Somewhere around 120-ish. So it's a dance BPM. Just have your open hi-hats hit every beat. Very, excuse me, very simple. So I didn't say my shout-out. So it's very frosty. Loner Square says work. Is Ozone similar to Parametric EQ or better? Ozone has a lot of stuff. It's not just an EQ. It has a compressor. It has an imager. Just go to isotope.com. You can learn more. Am I reading old comments? I think I am. Sorry. Jack Triple, what's up? Trippy Red? Yeah, I'm reading old comments. Wow, I'm feeling real salty right now. You got to do a DJ Paul, DJ Screw later on, though. Would be fire. We don't get that request a lot, but I appreciate that. What's up, Die Hard? Why people think Ableton is better than FL? People like what they know, so I'm not quite sure. It could be a sound thing. It could be a starter plugins thing. It could be anything. What's up? What's up, Splash? What's up, Q-Dog? So let me just continue this, just so people who watch it back on the replay don't get to watch a bunch of banter. So we're just going to have the open hi-hat, the open hi-hat hit on the beat. So it's 1 2 3 4. So we're going to contrast the open hi-hat, and then the hi-hat's playing triplets. So it's going to go tut tut tut, 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. So we need it. All right, sorry, FL froze up. Yeah, Django, I said, what's up? I said, I'm doing okie dokie. I guess you missed that part when I said I was doing okie dokie. And I said, you probably weren't going to expect me to say dokie, but I'm doing okie dokie. Awesome, Django. I didn't skip you. I guess you just missed the part. You can rewind the replay. You'll see it. Okay. So the hi-hats are going to be triplets. So it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. So that's the whole thing. Again, kind of bounces off what we did before. It's the contrast thing, but you can't draw triplets in the sequencer. It's just not that easy unless you turn your swing parameter all the way up, which is not an easy way to do it. So you have to go into the piano roll, and here's why people don't know they can make triplets, because you need to know you can do it. So go to pattern two, right click, go to piano roll, change your snap to grid to 1/3 beat, and now draw on your notes. Now it's going to play. This is why some of your, you know, rhythms or timings are off, because you want to do a triplet timing, but you're trying to do it in quarter timing. So triplets are the way to do it. So it's 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. Let's turn down the open hi-hats a bit. And, you know, I can cut out the open hi-hat, so I mean the closed hi-hat, so it's not too repetitive. And that's the whole thing. That's the whole bounce, is that triplet. Okay, so that's really the secret. Everything else is stuff you pretty much know. Let's grab a clap from the Ultimate Drum Kit from theproducerkit.com. We just need a simple clap, nothing crazy. Clean clap, where the high clap might work. Or snare clap, one of these is gonna work. Okay, so let's grab that. And let's put that on the 3 and the 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So listen to your metronome. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 2, clap. That clap's a little heavy. Let's try high clap. A little long. I like clean clap, but let's use a fade. Shorten it out a bit. I didn't shorten it. We have to manually use an envelope with a short decay for the volume. There we go. Yeah, I do have drum kits. They're at busyworksbeats.com/products. We like the X drums. You hear the sounds all the time on hit records on the billboards. X drums are so ubiquitous. I try to use other sounds. So you notice the bounce, it's really from that triplet timing. It's really all it is. But, you know, honorable C note is very good at being minimalistic, even though it's not minimalistic if you listen to the track. It's like a string and like a haunted bell thing. I don't even know where he got the sound from, but we'll create our own. So with the 808, let's see what 808s they have in the Ultimate Kit, just to kind of keep it all in one. We need an 808 that's really long, and we can dirty it up later. 808 science drums are always good. But I'm trying to stick to one kit at a time. So these are kind of short, which is fine. Titanic or either Vibe, Clean, or Titanic. One of these. I'm just going to pick the first one. It says A, but I want to triple check the tuning. Shout out to everybody in here who's learning a Trippie Redd style. Go to detect pitch regions, and you can see it goes from B to A. So A is the longer side, so we're going to go to our envelope. You need to tune it to A. So reset your root note, then right click on A. That's how you tune it in FL Studio. Whoops. Now, honorable C note is very, like, he uses half steps a lot. Now, I'm not trying to break down his style, but I'm just saying, it's not even, you know, you can't really say it's his, but I'm just saying in haunted music in general, especially in horror music, they use a lot of half steps. You can go back and listen to Halloween theme song, or listen to like Friday the 13th. I'm not sure actually for Friday the 13th, but I know for like Halloween, the one with Michael Myers, it's a lot of half steps. Okay, so we have to dirty up the 808 too. So it's not gonna be a clean 808. Now, I'm assuming that he starts with the 808. So let's. So the question is, do we want to go up or down a half step? Boom, boom, go down. Go down one more. That might be too much of a resolve. So try using half steps before you do whole steps. M rhythmizer, I've never heard of it. Nope. Tempo is 120. Okay, now for your 808s, let's dirty it up before I get into all the technical stuff. So you want to distort the 808, but try and keep the bass. So in this case, usually I would parallel process the 808, but we're not going to get that ridiculous today because FL Studio does not do a good job with plug and delay compensation. So I'm trying to decide if I want to use Super GT or trying to think of what distortion unit I want to use. Let's go with, why am I blowing blank on distortion? Let's try Supercharger GT. And because it has a mix level, I want to mix the distortion in. And let's crank the, where are we at? Saturation to hot mode, which is basically distortion. Oh, decapitator does, yeah. But the thing is, when you start saturating, you lose a lot of low end. So it's a balance game. Let's pull this down an octave, control down. Now we can distort it a little bit heavier. I don't like that distortion. It just doesn't sound good. You know a guy who produced for Trippie? That's awesome, man. I didn't know Trippie would blow up like he did. My goodness. Sheesh. He just came out of nowhere almost. Welcome to BusyWorks. Beats.com. He's bashing this off of basing. Oh, I don't know why I said bashing. Yeah, I'm... Drop that. I pull up in a drop top. Whatever that song is, Gummo. I don't know the name. Usually, you would probably think the song would be called Drop Dead or something, but it's called Gummo. So let's try half steps first. Do punish mode on decapitator. Distort the 808 a little harder. Again, horror music. Very half step based. Okay, now I'm just gonna repeat it. Now again, go to snap the grid, 1/3 beat. And you want your 808 endings to have the triplet. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you can bounce around a lot. So we can go up an octave. Again, half steps, one note away, so it goes half step, half step. So you can create your own kind of ending. I'm just going to use that one for now and maybe switch it up on the next one, make it unique. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Boom. Wait, 1, 2. And again, same thing, triplet timing. Now here I'm just gonna try using an octave up, but I don't know what this is gonna sound like. It's probably gonna sound crazy. I like the last two, I don't know about the first two. Just something different, you know, switching it up. So it's all about that triplet. That's the real key. Camel Crusher, yeah, they stopped making that. They don't have it out. It's probably like copies of it floating around, but they don't produce it anymore. Now we need a kick that can match with the 808. I have to turn off my mic so I can hear the bass. We'll be right back. So that's how you get the rhythm saucy. Hold on. That's how you get that rhythm saucy. Now, one more thing you could do is go back and change up the hi-hats a bit. I mean, that's all we really need for the rhythm. I'm not going to go crazy. Now, the hard part is trying to figure out the musicality over that and still making it feel musical, but not overly musical. So this is going to be the harder part, finding the right sounds, like haunted sounds, because there's thousands and thousands of Omnisphere sounds. So we have to narrow it down. Let's open up Omnisphere 2. Let me see what the kick sounds like if we have a hit on the snare. I don't think I recall that happening, but let's see if that works. Where are we at? Pattern 6. The clap is hidden during the kick. What are you talking about? Come on, man. Get your listening game up, man. Get your listening game up, man. Remember Terrence Howard? Man. Get it up, man. Feel me, man. You gotta get your ears up, man. Do you feel me, man? Okay. Omnisphere. I forgot what I was doing. I'm going to type in keywords haunted. If something actually pulls up. Wow, stuff pulled up. Haunted bell tones. What does this sound like? We can definitely layer that. So what I'm going to do is go to multi. And we're going to start using Omnisphere like old synths, which allow you to layer. Change this one to channel 1 so you can hear it. We're going to go to... whatever they call this, I guess a patch, patch 2, and then type in haunted again. And see what we can find. Now again, all this stuff is not necessarily in the Omnisphere library. It could be from Keyscape. So I need to turn off my mic so I can hear these sounds. It's really hard to hear. But this, again, it's all about triplets. Start using triplets to get your drum rhythms like this. All right, so what I did with the chords, I'm just using these for background chords for ambience to fill up dead space. I'm also going to find like a melody element. Hold on, let me answer your questions real quick. Freestyle on the beat, Frosty. I mean, sorry, yeah, Frosty. Make this. Great video from Mexico. What's up, Urbanos? Urbanos. ¿Puedo ir al baño? No melodic and dark enough. Not melodic and dark enough. Yeah, we didn't get to the melody yet. Which is better, Nexus or Omnisphere? Omnisphere, probably, for what you're at. I mean, I don't know what you're trying to do, but probably Omnisphere, because it's a lot of sounds, but Nexus is very organized. But they're both organized. Okay, so yeah, I'm just using this for background filler, so we can use it for reverb. Then we're going to find the haunted kind of melodic thing. Somehow we're at like 80,000 CPU. Like, what plugin is causing that much? We didn't even use anything. We have Decapitator. Is it Omnisphere? One of these plugins is running us up a bill. But anyway, with the MIDI, the trick with the chords is that... And hold on. Move this over. Trick with the chords is that you take one note and you drop it down a half step. So we're taking A, dropping it down, flattening A. That's all we did. And I did the same thing with the middle note, just flatten it down with A. Just pull it down one note. So let's figure out what plugin's eating up so much stuff. It's probably Omnisphere. If it is Omnisphere, I'm going to convert this to audio. Now here's the thing, Omnisphere was running our CPU up from 17 all the way up to 87. So in that case, I would say never get Omnisphere. But I don't mean don't ever get it. I just mean it doesn't matter how good a plugin is. If it's running up your resources, you can't use it anyway. So, you know, that happens sometimes with Serum because there's so many voices involved with the plugin. I know it's not the plugin's fault, but my CPU should not be cracking out at 87 just because of one Omnisphere. So since that is eating up so many resources, I'm swapping it out for Nexus just to show you how it's not like one or the other. I just reach for Omnisphere a little bit more. So we need to swap out the sound. The chord's a little off because the bass line changed. That bottom note here. This should not be C, because remember our bass went from C sharp to C. Need a more haunted sound. Sometimes if you're too musical, you can make it sound too resolved, and that could take away from the haunted feel. So always stick with the half step thing. Sometimes even it doesn't matter what PC I have, these plugins are just insanely, they hog up resources. So sometimes it's not even about your PC and what it can handle. It's just that Omnisphere decided to go wild. But that's rare that Omnisphere takes up that much space. Okay, so now I need to come up with the melody. So we're probably going to layer like an organ sound over something. Now here's where Omnisphere comes into play, because you're looking for so many different sounds. Now again, we're trying to mimic a song without copying the song. So I'm doing the best I can as far as not copying everything about it, but it's the same techniques. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Sphere has so many weird sounds. Like, I went through like 20 sounds just now, and they were so weird that it made me stop looking. That's the one thing about Omnisphere. Like, yes, it has 20,000 sounds, but they're like super weird, and they're not, it's not like organized by genre. It's just, I mean, yeah, there's a genre, but I mean, it's really like, and then if you don't find what you want, you're going to be searching for days and days and days and days and days. That's why I like Nexus, because it's so hyper-focused with their expansions. They're not worried about having a billion sounds. They're worried about having the focus sounds. So that's one thing about Nexus. So I'm trying to find a decent combo, you know, sound. But if I'm taking too long, I just get, at least the melody's there. You know, I'm not going to obsess over the specific sound for hours and hours. At this point, it's just about adding mutes, adding a vocal, and you're done, really. So, you know, usually mutes are done after the fact. I don't know what this sounds like over my headphones, but I'm not going to overly mix this and take forever. You know, if it's laid down, it's laid down. So let's record some vocal ideas. So finding the key is going to be a little bit different because we're using Mondo Mod, which is changing the pitch slightly. All right, I had to add a filter to my voice. Let's add autotune in here. Let's get our Travis Scott Trippy Red on. And I believe our key, I didn't map out our key. Our key was, let me see here. Yeah, I'm gonna do the vocals right now. Let me set up my autotune. So B is in. No C. C sharp, no D. We have D sharp. It's hard to hear. B is in there. No F. F sharp's in there, no G. G sharp's in there. No A. Back to B.
I pull up in a drive top right.
We can't copy the melody, so I'm trying to think of something else we can do. Again, when I do these kind of like replica styles, it's really hard not to use the same exact melody somebody else did, because that's what's going to give it that vibe.
Hey,
that's still the melody, huh? So I have to create my own melody that's not like theirs. Let's loop record.
Baker's F, hey, roll it this way. I can hear right, right, right. 16 off right, right, same east side. Right, red, all right, right. Hello, keep it all right. Spring to get beat, say, look ain't no lie. Went from daddy to the bike. Now I think it's our night. Rollin' them, getting them by. Rollin' them, getting them by. All day, no right. Rotate, low light.
Look, I'm saying the saying the same thing over and over again. Let me do it again. Also, the vocal feels too compressed.
Don't lie.
All right, we're good. Let me do it one more time. Again, we're doing phonetic lyric.
Obey, oh my, oh me, oh my, we're for study, all right, now I pull up and I slide, oh my, I got, let me tell you what I ride, oh ski, the ride, I'll tell you what I ride, low key, no eyes, low key, no eyes, when I pull up and I ride, and I drop out in the fight, yeah, yeah, I buy, got a AK in the vibe, bling, bling, if I.
That's the Trippie Redd part. Let's do like Travis Scott. Trippie Redd, I mean, once you have it kind of locked in, it is what it is. Let's do like a Travis Scott style.
Obey, oh my, oh me, oh my, we're for study, all right. Now I pull up and I slide, oh my, I got, let me tell you what I ride. Oh, ski, the ride, I'll tell you what I ride. Low key, the ride.
Only thing is, I'm too low for this track, but I want to get to those. But you have to make sure it sits over top of the bass. So let's try that.
Obey, oh my, oh me, oh my, we're for study, all right, now I pull up and I slide, oh my, I got, let me tell you what I ride, oh, ski, the ride, I'll tell you what I ride, low key, the eyes, low key, the eyes, when I pull up and I ride, and I drop out in the fight. Like, oh my god, right in his soul, my god. Thirsty on the window, right like, oh my god. On the Freddy imitation, and the really imitations. Driving living limitations, feel like getting in the bases. Oh my, what a wonderful time. I, oh me, oh my god. Obey, oh my, oh me, oh my, we're for study, all right, now I pull up and I slide, oh my, I got, let me tell you what I ride, oh ski, the ride, I'll tell you what I ride, low key, the eyes, low key, the eyes, when I pull up and I ride, and I drop out in the fly. Viola with the guys, I pull up in your ride. What a wonderful night. I dance to the sky. In the moon and the stars, and I'm loading it right. In the moon and the stars, and I'm loading it right. AK, Nia, Nag, I don't play with you guys. I pull up with the vibe. Then I vibe, vibe, vibe. Yellow flame with the fire. Yeah, I pull up with your squad. Donny Yolo with the side.
I think we're done. I can't come up with any more melodic riffs or any more motifs, I meant to say. Let me flesh that out. Move it over a little bit. Yeah, it's not much I can think of, but oh me, oh my. That kind of lock, that was a good hook. I don't think we can really beat that hook. But the goal is to see if you can beat yourself. Pause. Let me hear that back over the monitors. Also, let me duplicate this out. Hold on. Slide that bad boy over here. Let's route it to the mixer. Where are we at? I don't know what that is. Put it to track 10, 11. Travis Scott's vocal is going to get a little more reverb than Trippie Redd's.
Obey, oh my, oh me, oh my, we're fraternity, all right, now I pull up and I slide, oh my, I got, let me tell you what I ride, oh, ski, the ride, I'll tell you what I ride, low key, the eyes, when I pull up and I ride, and I drop out in the fire. Yeah.
So I want to wrap up the stream because people on the watching the replay don't want to watch a bunch of filler. So I'm going to wrap the stream up. I'm going to answer your questions real quick. Is that an 808? Yes. We ran it through a plugin called Decapitator. Wow, my mic's way down here. How did that happen? We ran it through a plugin called Decapitator by Sound Toys, a great company which makes creative plugins like Micro Shift, which I used on the vocal. So Decapitator, you can put it on punish mode. And that's how we got that distorted, very saturated sound for the 808. And what's the best VST for mastering? Try Ozone stuff from Isotope. They have a lot of stuff packed in there. Is it better to use Pro Tools for quality purposes? That's up for debate. It's a very broad debate. All right, so True Friends got best VST, Ozone, Okay, so I got to wrap this up again. People watching the replay don't want to watch a bunch of junk. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.